press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello everyone. I hope that you all are fit and fine. And also welcome back to our class, social study class. Okay. So in the previous class, we already learnt about, you have any idea what we learned in the previous class? Yes, we already learnt about the physical features of our India in details manner, isn't it? So and also we learn about what? Yes, the climate of our India, isn't it? So we already learnt about the three seasons of our India. Okay, so first one is summer, second one is rainy season, and third one is winter season, isn't it? So here next one is we are going to learn about soils of India. Okay, so first, soil formation is very beautiful process. Okay, so it is very beautiful process. It takes 100 years to form soil. Okay, how many years? It takes 100 years to form. Okay, for the soil. Okay, the factors involved in the soil are parenting rocks. Which are the factors involved in the formation of soil? You have any idea how the soil is formed? Yes, now we are going to learn about the formation of soil. It's very beautiful process of formation of soil. Okay, so here it's the factors involved in the soil are parenting rocks. Okay, so climate, vegetation, and then animals and microorganism. Okay, so these factors is help to formation of soil. These factors are helps to formation of soil. Which are the factors? Parenting rocks, climate, and then natural vegetation, animals, and then microorganism. Okay, so here parenting rocks refers to the original rocks on which soils are formed. Okay, so parenting rocks means it's a original rock. Okay, so by that the soil will be formed. Okay, so original rocks on which soils are formed, if the original rock is basalt, okay, so the soil form as the black soil. So if the original rock is basalt, so that soil is formed as, yes, black soil. Okay, so if the original rock is ancient crustal, okay, so metamorphic rock, the form of red soil, if the that form the, yes, red soil. So this process is very beautiful process. Okay, the soil formation is very beautiful. Yes, for what? Yes, formation. Okay, so here now we are going to learn about the soils of India. Okay, so here how the soil is formed? Yes, soil is very important natural resources to us. Soil is very important natural resources to us. Okay, soil is very natural resources. Natural, yes, resources. Natural resource to us. We can't make the soil now. Yes, it is the natural resources to us. Okay, so here it is a top layer of the earth. So we can see it now, soil. Yes, in the outside, it is in the top layer of the earth. Soil is in the top layer of the earth. Okay, so here where plants grow. So soil is very important to plants now to grow. Yes, so it's very important to grow. Okay, so here it is a form where natural forces break. So it is formed by, yes, natural resources. Yes, so it's break large rocks. You know the large rocks now? Yes, in the mountain sides we can see it very very big large. Yes, rocks, we can see it now. Yes, so the soil formed by the breaking of, yes, large rocks, okay, into a smaller piece. These big rocks break down as a small pieces. Okay, so here These pieces are further broken down into sand and salt, okay, and carried to the different places by running water and wind. So these big rocks what break down into a small pieces, okay. So these pieces carried by running river to one place to another place, okay. So these rocks carried by the rivers one place to another place, okay. So here, and then it's all this is very slow process. This all is very slow process. Already I told you now, it takes 100 years to form soil, isn't it? So it is very slow process, okay. The soil formation is very slow process, okay. So here it takes thousands of years for a layer of the soil to form. So fertile is the most important features of soil. Fertile, so soil must be a fertile soil. It is the most important feature, okay. Here the fertile soil of various form place. It's fertile soil, we can't be see the fertile soil all over the India, okay. It changes to place to place, okay. Fertile soil is changes to place, okay, by the watch, yes. So by the condition of climate, natural vegetations, okay. So this process is very slow process, we can say it, okay. So here manure and fertilizer are added to the soil to make it fertile. If the soil is not fertile, what we add, you know the farmers now? Yes. What they do if the soil is not fertile, what they do? Yes, they add the manure and humus, okay. So to make the soil very fertile, okay. So here fertile soil is good for growing crops. Why the fertile soil is very good? Yes, the fertile soil is good for growing crops, okay. Crops is very important to us now. Yes, we have to eat to get energy now. If I am standing here to, what should I do? Yes, I have to eat, okay. So we have to be healthy now. So crops is very important, isn't it? So we get the food, okay. So the fertile soil is good for growing many crops. Fertile soil is good for growing many crops, okay. So here many types of soil are found in India, okay. We can see the many soils of India, in India. So here, so first one, which soil we can see here? Yes, so this classified into the, okay, many, yes. So it's be classified here, okay. So first one is alluvial soil. First one is alluvial soil. First is alluvial soil, okay. So alluvial soil, it's in the color in, yes, which color we can see in the alluvial soil? Yes, so gray color, light brown and yellowish color we can see the alluvial soil, okay. So it is not the particular color, so we can see the, yes, light gray, yellowish, okay, brown. So here we have read our earlier now, what we read in earlier, yes, that the Himalayan rivers bring them with them large quantity of alluvium, isn't it? We already told it now, yes. They in the Himalaya, what happened, these rivers carried, yes, this Himalayan, so what the river carry? The river carry alluvium soil, okay. So here bring with the large quantities, okay, this soil being rivers carry the large quantities of alluvium, okay. So here this is deposit on the river's banks. So here, so this is, for example, this is the river now, okay. So here we can see in the side of the river, we call it banks now. So we can see this soil in the banks of rivers, okay. In the banks of river, we can see the alluvial soil, okay. So here, so this what this is deposit on the river's banks. Okay, the alluvial soil is very fertile soil. So this soil is very fertile soil. Yes. Why it's very fertile? Yes. So they added naturally we can say it is the silt sediments are in the soil. So that's why this soil is very fertile soil. Okay. So here. The Deccan Plateau alluvial soil found in the deltas formed by the rivers. So we already know the deltas now. Yes, Ganga and Yamuna form the delta east side now. Yes. So here in the many we can see the Godavari delta, Krishna delta, and also yes. Okay. So here Sundarbans delta. So in this in that river side we can see the alluvial soil. It's very fertile soil. Okay. So here the crops grown in these regions are including paddy, wheat, and then maize, sugarcane, pulses, oil seeds, and vegetables, tobacco, cotton, jute. Many crops are grown in this. Yes, soil. Okay, why we grow many crops? Because it very fertile soil. Okay, we can't it's not need to add any manure. Okay, so humus we can't add it na to fertile the soil. Yes, so here this soil is naturally fertile soil. So that's why the many farmers grow many crops. Okay, so here this is about the alluvial soil. Okay. So here next one is which one? Yes, next one is black soil. We know it now, black soil. Yes, black soil insists that it's in the color of black. Okay, so here black soil has been formed from the lava rocks. You know the lava na? Yes, in the middle of mountains, big mountains, the lava we call Jwalamukhi. Yes, so here we can see it fire na? Yes, so it's formed with the lava rocks. Okay, black soil formed with the lava rocks. It is black in color. It is in which color? Yes, it is in black color. So it is called as black lava soil. So it is called as black lava soil. Okay, so black soil is mostly found in Deccan Plateau region. So already I told you na, Deccan Plateau we already read na. Yes, we found in the Deccan Plateau in the southern part of our India na. Yes, so we can found the black soil in the Deccan Plateaus. Okay, so which covers a large area of Maharashtra and then Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. So its black soil covered the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, and then Gujarat. Okay, so black soil can be hold a large amount of moisture is very important now in the soil. Yes, so it is suitable for growing crops like cotton, sugarcane, wheat, millets, tobacco, and then oil seeds. It's very good for growing. Yes, sugarcane, cotton. Okay, so we can grow it in the black soil. So for example, if you want to see in the nearest to the Dangere na, you can, if you go to the Hariyar in the entrance, you can see the black soil there. Okay, so it is very good for growing cotton and then sugarcane. Okay, so this is about the black soil. Okay, next one is red soil. So here red soil, so we can see it in the outside now. Yes, which color it is? Yes, it is in the red color. Okay, so this name is instead that, yes, indicates that, yes, it is in the color of red. Okay, also here that this type of soil is found in the parts of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Jharkhand, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, okay? So this type of soil we can found in these states, okay? Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Jharkhand, Telangana, okay? We can found the red soil there. So the red soil is not very fertile soil. So compared to the alluvial soil, this red soil is not very fertile soil, okay? It's not very fertile soil. So but its fertile can be increased to some extent by adding manure and chemical fertilizers, okay? So if the soil is not fertile now, what the farmers do? Yes, they add some manure, isn't it? So we called it in Kannada gobra, we called it na, yes. So these chemical fertilizers and then we manure we can add it to the red soil to make the red soil as a very fertile soil, okay? So next one, a few crops are grown in red soil. Very few crops we can grow in the red soil, not many crops. We can grow some few crops, okay? We can alluvial soil, there are many crops grown in the alluvial soil, but the red soil is not very fertile. So the farmers add to grow crops, they add manure and then chemical fertilizers, okay? So here in the red soil there is a very few crops we can grow here, okay? So here they include paddy, okay, ragi, millets, pulses and then vegetables, okay? So with these crops we can grow in the red soil, okay? In hilly areas, that have this type of soil, potatoes and peanuts are grown, and also here in the hilly areas they grow potatoes and then peanuts, okay, in the red soil. So next one is laterite soil. So this is the laterite soil. So here the laterite soil is found in small areas in Maharashtra, Odisha, West Bengal, Karnataka and Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Bihar, Assam and then Meghalaya. So here already I told you in the previous class now, we compare to the whole India now, we can't get the same soil and also same climate, okay, and also natural vegetation. It changes to place to place, okay? So here this laterite soil we can found in the Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, West Bengal, Karnataka. So here we can see the red soil now. Yes. So in this part of India we can found the laterite soil. Okay. So here it develops as a result of leaching in places where it rains heavily. So this leaching means if these parts we can found this laterite soil where the heavy rains. Yes. So here this leaching in places where it rains heavily. So okay. So in this laterite soil there will be grow many crops. Okay. So like paddy, ragi, and then tea, coffee, rubber, and fruits are grown in this soil by adding manure, okay? So by adding manure we can grow the ragi, okay, paddy or many other crops, okay? This compared to the alluvial soil, this soil is not very fertile, okay? So by adding the manure and chemical fertilizer we make it as a very fertile soil. After that we grow many crops in the laterite soil, okay? So here, and also it is good for growing fruits, and also it is good for growing fruits, okay? Laterite soil is commonly used to make bricks, you know, na bricks. Yes. So this laterite soil is good for making bricks. If I ask which soil is suitable for making bricks, means which soil? Yes, laterite soil is good for making bricks. Okay, so next one is mountain soil. So it's mountain soil. Next one is mountain. You have any idea? You get the any idea? Mountain soil. Where we get this mountain soil? Any idea? Yes, we get in the mountains, isn't it? So that's why it's called the mountain soil. Yes. So here, mountain soil is found on hill slopes. Okay, hill slopes is called mountain soil. So this soil is found in the Jammu and Kashmir, and then Himachal Pradesh have mountain soil. We can found in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh. Okay, so this soil is found in these places. Okay, mountain soil is rich in humus. So here, rich in humus. Okay, so humus means, yes, so fertilizer formed from dead leaves and plants of the soil. So this is called very fertile soil. Okay, so here we can grow the wheat, maize, and then barley, fruits, tea, coffee, spices, and then we can grow many important fruits now. Yes, in the Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, they grow saffron, apples is very important now. Yes, so here in the mountain soil we can grow many crops. Okay, it's very fertile soil. So here we can grow the spices. Okay, so are grown in such soil. And then if you go to the Jammu and Kashmir, we can found apples as a tomatoes. Okay, so they can't they grow in a large number. Okay, so they grow the apples and spices, okay, fruits in the large numbers. Okay, so here next one is which soil? Yes, desert soil. You have any idea where we found this desert soil? Desert or sandy? You have any idea? Yes. This type of soil is found in the, yes, desert of Rajasthan and then Gujarat, in the part of, yes, west part of our India. We can found the desert soil, a sandy soil. Okay, in the part of west, yes, in the part of, yes, west. Okay, so here this is dry soil. So this is very dry soil. You know the sand now? Yes, so it's very dry now. Yes, in this west part we can found the western desert now. So this soil is very dry soil. This soil is very dry soil. So here sandy soil is not fertile. So if you want to grow crops, means what you have, which are the first main features to grow the crops in the soil? Yes, it must and should be very fertile, then only we grow the crops, otherwise we can't, isn't it? So here if the soil is not fertile, we can add the manure or humus or, okay, or chemical fertilizer, but here this soil is very dry soil. Okay, it's not very fertile soil. So if the water is made available to this soil, this type of land, the crops like wheat, millets, okay, barley, maize, pulses and cotton can be grown. I already told you in the previous class now water is not available in the Rajasthan, isn't it? So through the canal, which canal? Yes, Indira Gandhi canal, the government provided water to the farmers for the purpose of irrigation and other domestic uses. Okay, so this soil is not fertile soil. So by adding the water, we can make it as a fertile soil, and also we can grow the crops, wheat, millets, okay, and then pulses, cotton can be grown in that soil. Okay, so here In the soil, we can find the many worms, okay, what we call earthworms. So earthworm is very important in soil. It's earthworms help the soil. They convert dead leaves, okay, and plants remains into a rich natural fertilizer. We call it as a natural fertilizers, na? Yes, by browning, yes, into the soil. They make it loose. They make it as a loose. This allowing air to enter the soil. This makes the soil more fertile. So earthworms is also very important to it is also take the important part making soil fertilizer. Okay, so earthworm is very important in the soil. Okay, so here we already know the types of soil, isn't it? So this soil is by breaking the large rocks into small pieces. So it takes how many years? It takes so many years to, yes, so formation of soil. So this, it takes soil to formation, okay? If you are seeing the soil now in outside, it takes so many years to form, okay? So the main now the in the soil soil also very important what we called it a problem, okay? So in the soil also there is a many problems, okay, like soil erosion. Okay, soil erosion, you heard that? Yes, we call it soil erosion. So manure and fertilizer added to the soil to make it more fertile. So already I told you now, if the soil is not fertile, we add the chemical fertilizers to make it soil very fertile, na? Yes. So, but in some part of our country, so not in the every part of our country, some part of our country, the soil is not looked after properly. So, the soil, it's a natural resources to us, na? Yes, we can't pay for the soil, na? So it's a natural resources to us. In some part of our country, the soil will be very neglected. Why? Yes, the soil is not looked properly. We are not looking properly in a soil. Yes, they are cut and grass is pulled out, which makes the soil infertile. We all are what we are doing? Yes, we are just plucking the soil. What? We plucking the grass now, and also we are cutting the trees. Okay, this make the soil infertile. Day by day, what we are seeing? Yes, day by day we are seeing the deforestation, isn't it? Yes. So this make the soil infertile. Trees also take the very important part in the making the soil fertile. Okay. So if we cut the soil, what happened? Yes, soil became infertile. Okay. So here, rainwater and strong winds also carry the soil away. So if you see it now, rainwater and also, yes, winds carry the soil, okay? So which makes the soil infertile. It's also make the soil infertile, okay? So this is called soil erosion. So it's called as a soil erosion, okay? So the we make the soil fertile now, yes. So the following steps can be stop for soil erosion. We had to stop some, yes, we are doing the problem in nature now, yes. So here, if you want to stop the soil erosion, we had to take some steps, okay? What we had to take? We had to take some steps to make it soil fertile, okay? So here, we should to control the cutting down of the trees, okay? We first main things we have to stop the cutting of trees. What we have to stop? Yes, we have to stop the cutting of trees. I already told it now. Yes, day by day what we are doing. Yes, we are doing the deforestation. So in the name of development, isn't it? In the name of development, we are day by day we are doing, yes, deforestation. So here we have to stop the cutting of the trees. First main thing is we have to stop the cutting of the trees, and then we should plant more trees. We have to plant more trees, okay? So if you are getting the oxygen now properly, it's because of the trees. What the trees do? Yes, the trees, what they do, it's make the air very pure now. Yes, if you are taking oxygen means it, we have to gratitude to the trees, okay? So here we have to plant more trees, okay? We have to plant more trees. Trees helps to hold the soil together. If you see in the roots, okay, tree roots now, it's what it's make, yes, it holds the soil together, isn't it? It holds the soil, okay? It holds the soil, these roots, okay? So here, these particular important along the hills slopes. So we should, embankments should be built around fields. We have to, embankments, we have to, what? Yes, embankments should be built on the, around the fields, okay? So we should not leave, what? We should not leave fields empty, isn't it? If you see in these fields now, we should not, what we should not do? Yes, we should not leave the field empty, okay? At least we have to grow grass, okay? If there is no crop in the field now, what we have to do? Yes, we should save the land by a grass covering. We have to grow the crops, what? Grass. If there is no crops in the field now, what we have to do? Yes, we have to, yes, grow the grass in the field. We should not leave the field empty, okay? Otherwise what happened? Yes, so the winds will take soil one place to another place. What happened? It's make the soil infertile, okay? So these all the steps we had to take to make the soil fertile, okay? Otherwise soil erosion will be a very big problem, okay? So here, this is about the soils of India. We already know it now, how the soil is formed. Yes, the soil is formed by the what? Big rocks. It takes 100 years to form, okay? And weathering it means so it's these big large rocks make soften and breaking down the rocks in rocks. This happens due to the climate and every day, okay? So here, due to the heat of the sun, due to the heat of the sun, what happened? Yes, it's break down now. All the large, these big rocks will be break down due to the heat of the sun. Temperature rises and the rocks expand at night. So time the rocks contract due to the regular expansion and contraction of rocks, they break up into small sediments, okay? So sometimes the rocks break down because they are contact with the water. So, and also I already told you now, so the rivers carried the soil. So if the continuous contact in the river, so it's break, and also river water also break down the big rocks, okay? So due to the heat of the what? Sun and also the river, it's break down, okay? And so here it's reacts with the water, okay? So they are the extracted out of rocks. The rocks finally became weak. So if the continuously the water is what contact with the mountains meant what happened? Yes, automatically the rocks became very weak. Okay, so they break with the leaves. Okay, from the tree complete their cycle. And also after that what happened? Trees. Next one is trees. Yes. So, and they break when the leaves, we already know that in which season? Yes, in the autumn season, the leaves will fall down now. Yes, after completing the cycle, isn't it? They fall down and decompose and finally became one off with soil. And also it's became the one off with soil. So, if the tree leaves will fall down, what happened? It's became with, it's one off with the soil. It mix with the soil, okay? And the animal excretions and also the dead of animals, yes. So, became one of them with, okay? Dead remains, plants and animals known as humus. So, it's called as the humus, okay? Dead leaves and the dead animals are one of with the soil, no? So it's called as the humus, okay? So it adds fertile in the soil, okay, and make it sticky. So it's make it sticky. Earthworm is also, it's take very important part in the, yes, making of soil fertile. So here, so in this class we already learnt about the formation of soil and the types of the soil. We can see the main, how many types? We can see the main 6 types of soil. First one is alluvial soil. We can found in the, yes, Himalaya, okay, and then black soil, red soil, laterite soil, mountain soil and then desert soil. So we can found all over country, we can't found one soil, isn't it? So we can found these types of soil in our India, okay? So I hope that you all learnt about the types of soil and also the formation of soil, okay? It's very important to growing crops. Soil must be fertile soil, okay? So this is all about the soil. Soil is very soil is natural resources like air, water, okay? So it is also a natural resources, okay? I hope that you all understand this and make practice, okay, at homes and do the revisions, okay? So practice well at your homes, okay? Study well. All the best. Thank you.